CQ, CQ. Anybody around tonight? This is W1UJ in Webster, Mass. Calling for the 10 meter flying saucer net, or what seemed to be labeled that. Anybody around?
This is A1B. Yeah, how you doing, Jay?
Who's that? Is that Brad?
Yes, it is.
What's your call, Brad? I'm sorry, I was flipping antennas at the same time. K1BAB?
That's correct. K1 Bravo Alpha Bravo.
What's up, brother? Yeah, good evening. You hear anybody else in there calling?
I think somebody tried to call when you called back to me.
Okay. Go ahead, take over. I'll keep it short. Go ahead, take over, Brad. See if you can ring anybody up. I can't hear anybody up here.
This is W1TR. Do you hear me? Over.
I copy you, sorry. You probably can hear a lot more out of cell than I can. Good evening. K1TR, we got Brad and hi, W1UJ. Go ahead, sorry. You want to do a call just to see if we get some... names in the roster for the Chiefs when they get back.
This is W1TR calling CQ for the flying saucer net. W1TR, I guess I got the beam pointed down towards Daniel. Oop, I don't want to go that far. Let's go back this way a little bit. Okay, so anyway, I wonder if anybody's around. W1TR. Okay, you got KB1JDX. Who else? Over. KC1IIX. Roger that. Anybody else? Over. No, I guess not. W1UJ, W1TR. Did you copy those stations? Over.
Sure did. I didn't copy the stations at all. Good evening, Vinny and KC1IIX. Now, if you wanna go ahead and run it through them, that'd be great, Terry. And I just wanna make a quick comment about you. I read your article on the new transceiver you're going on there. Seems pretty detailed. I wonder if that's what you're using tonight. And if you're interested, I've been recording these flying saucer nets for the last 2 weeks. You can critique your own audio from my house anyway, up here in Webster, Mass. There was one night that I recalled you had a little crunch to you, but it was something weird, but maybe it was something you can assess by listening to the recordings. But if you want to run it, Terry, that would probably be the best thing. I'll just be a windbag anyway. W1TR, W1UJ.
Yeah, we need to get K1ZE in here. He's the one with the big signal. I had fun writing that article. I'm not using the 8000 DLE this evening, but I'm using the 100D, which is its younger brother. And it's pretty much it's not exactly the same radio. It's 100 watts instead of 200. And it's an earlier digital board and a different RF board, but it's essentially the same radio. The same software runs it, and the architecture of the firmware is about the same, except that the other one takes advantage of some things that are different in the hardware, particularly the pure signal. So essentially, from my point of view, when I was testing, there was not a lot of difference between the radios. You had to go to the lab to make measurements to see any difference. Over.
That's pretty cool. Yep. Yeah, I didn't read it verbatim, but I just skimmed through it and thought it was pretty cool that I had just talked to you, the evening that I got QST, or the next day, on Thursday. But let me check in with Brad here real quick to check in. So yeah, Brad, I was just talking about, I don't know if you're a member of the ARRL, but the QST this month had a write-up by Terry on a new transceiver, high-tech stuff. And then I'll turn it over to you, Terry, for... Yeah, Zeddy is down in KP2, just for full disclosure. He's down in St. Croix, Virgin Island. Doing radio stuff. There's a major contest this weekend, so if anybody wants to get on the phone, there might even be some activity here. Probably mid-morning to mid-afternoon is the best chances. But But check it throughout the day. Depending on your license class, you go down in frequency, you'll be pretty much better off. So Brad, what do you got going on over there, man? Maybe make a few contacts in the worked out prefixes contest this weekend. K1BAV, W1UJ.
Yeah, over here I'm hearing a lot of noise. I'm having trouble hearing tonight for some reason. But I believe you asked if I had made any contacts, is that correct?
No, I just made it this weekend. This weekend is a major contest.
Oh, yeah, I'll be on this weekend. After I get back Saturday, I have a good little trip I have to go on, but when I come back Saturday, I'll get on.
Let's see. All right, check. All right, cool. Well, I bumped the power up a little bit here. Try to make sure everybody can hear me. So go ahead, Terry. That's all I can copy from this end. We'll do a quick roll call, and I'll stand by if that's okay with you. You've got the best ears. W1TR with Brad, K1BAB, W1UJ.
Okay, let me go through the list of stations that I have on the list, and then let's see if I've missed some. I got KB1JDX, well, myself, KB1JDX, KC1IIX, W1UJ, KA1BAP. Any other stations I missed? I guess not. Well, I've been working on the HF Auto software in addition to the business with the 8000 DLE. There was some controversy with that 8000 DLE review because we had a unit, we were going to try to publish this back in November, but we couldn't do it because we had a problem with the original unit that was sent to us, so we had to send it back. Then the second unit had some questionable tests. We could not get some things to work, and it wasn't clear exactly how or why that was, and so we're consulting the known experts on the Apache Labs to resolve that, but it did not test very well in some cases, with particularly 17, 15 meters, and 12 meters with regard to transmit purity, and so we're not sure quite why that is. And the pure signal didn't work out the way we thought it should either. So there's been some flack. I've gotten some hate mail and all of that. And of course, I turn around and tell them, well, I didn't do the lab test. The lab guys down at ARRL did. So we'll see how that settles out. But the ARRL is still the lab, and that group is still working out further details to find out, you know, what the issue could be. And was there a cockpit error, or did we have another hardware error in the unit, or what? Software works on other units, so we don't know. So that was an interesting controversy. Anyway, I'm working on finalized, I think, or mostly finalized, the HF Auto software. If you have a PALSTAR HF Auto antenna tuner, I have software that will control that and make it track the transmitter VFO so that it doesn't do an autotune cycle, and it's always tuned up and ready to go no matter what frequency you're on, with about a 1.1 SWR, regardless of band, regardless of frequency, anything. So I've been working on that. Posted a final, well, not a final, but a good post of that. So over to you, KB1JDX. What are your comments for the net, W1TR?
What am I writing this off? What was that question again?
Yeah,
Okay, it was written in C#.net, 2015 Visual Studio, and it's about 15,000 lines of code. Over. Okay, it's W1TR. Well, I've done this sort of thing for a living for 50 years, since the early to the mid-60s, and C-sharp is a, kind of a relative to C++. It's similar, but it's kind of a cross between Java and C++. Over.
This W1TR, well, it looks like building VLSI. I've done that at one point in time, and other electrical stuff. If that's your profession, then it's understood, and it's pretty much routine that you can do that. Over to KC1IIX, W1TR, your comments, over. Who is it your brother making out? Oh, okay. Well, I'm not sure exactly where he is. Down in Danielson. So, if you have a beam point towards Boston, I'm in Ashford, near the highway, up at near Route 89 as it goes up to the highway, about two miles south of the highway. But I'm running a Yagi beam at about 70 feet, and I'm also running a kilowatt out. Over. Okay, well, I'm hearing you okay. You're not overly loud, but good readable, and so is Benny. He's about the same. I think I have the beam pointed more towards him than to you, so. Okay, any other comments? Over. Okay, heard about what? Which one? Over. Okay. I forget what date it is. It's on my calendar, but I'd have to go look. But we have a Central Mass meeting, Central Mass Amateur Radio meeting on the third Thursday of April. I think that's before the flea market you have, and I'll make an announcement then so that the people there who are in Central Mass, you know, the Worcester area, will know about it, because often they like to come down to the E-Cara flea market. Over. Okay, roger that. Well, that's kind of way over the other side of the state. I don't generally go over there too much. But Central Mass, that's up around, they meet up in Boylston, West Boylston, Mass. And so I go up there. I'm a kind of a member. I'm actually, at one time I was the secretary and I was a field day chairman. I was the, I'm on the board of directors for it. So that was convenient to me because when I went to work over at Hanscom here, near Lexington, Mass. That was sort of on the way home, kind of on a commute, because I had a 70-mile commute one way, and so I would go to that meeting, and I would use that repeater, the Paxton repeater, for commuting. So that's why I joined that club. But I want to try to spend more time with the Eastern Connecticut club. The weather hasn't been cooperating lately. So, okay. So I will mention it to the Samara club members, and hopefully they're closer, be more likely to come down and join the fleet of the our flea market. Over. Okay, and so down to W1JU, your comment, W1TR.
Terry, is that me, Terry? Yeah, okay, all right, Terry, I'm in here. Five is, I couldn't hear KC1 IAX, and I got Vinny light on the vertical. That's what I'm trying to use right now, too. Your signal's a little bit down on the vertical here, Terry, but I can hear those two guys a little bit better. I'm sure Brad can hear you. I don't think you're too far from me, Brad. But the Icara Flea Market is on 29th April at the Thompson Speedway. And that's the weekend, it looks like it's the weekend before Nearfest. And I think, I don't know when the meetings are, I haven't been going to them for a little while as well. The Icara meetings are usually at Dake Kimball Hospital in Putnam, Connecticut. But I think that's what KC1IIX was asking. And I think you might have busted Brad's call, Terry, Kilo 1 Bravo Alpha Bravo. Just in case, and I think that's it. Any other check-ins? Anybody around tonight? We'll wrap things up, and I'll upload the audio, and we'll go from there. Anybody else? Any other check-ins? This is WNUJ in Webster. Anybody copy anything? Oh, you copy? Is that you, Vinny? Awesome. Yep, I got you. I'm on my 160 meter vertical. It's about 100 feet up in the tree, inverted L, 5/8 wave inverted L. Vertical section's about 100 feet, and it's about 60 or 70 feet going towards the woods. So that's what I got. Awesome, Vinny. So you're in the log. I'll upload all this stuff to Log of the World, even if I can't hear you on the net. So that's what I got. Vinny's got me. Do you guys, Terry or Vinny, you want to try any other relays? One last chance, and we'll wrap things up.
Did we give K1BAB a chance to talk? W1TR, over.
Brad?
K1BAB. Yeah, I didn't hear any other relays come in. For some reason tonight I'm having a lot of trouble here and I got a lot of QRM. I switched switched antennas. I don't know if you can hear me as well on this one, but back to you guys.
Let's see if I got, I hear you fine. Hey, fine, Brad. You got anything tonight? You going to the flea market in April at the Thompson Speedway?
Yep, I plan to. Maybe I can find a better antenna there, something that'll get me higher up in the air over these hills. Over.
What are you using right now? What are your choices? You said you switched antennas. What were you using and what are you using now?
I was using a long wire, and I switched over to an Antron 99, and, I don't know if you guys can tell the difference or not, but back to you.
Brad, one more question. Are you got general? You got general, right? Or extra, don't you?
Do I have what?
Extra, amateur extra class license or general?
I have an extra class.
All right. So one antenna. I've had a huge success with. The biggest problem is you need an antenna tuner, but the noise is pretty low. It's actually kind of what I'm using now, kind of a flat top Marconi, but it's homemade open wire line feeding a dipole essentially. But we'll go over that at some point. Maybe when we see you at the flea market, or maybe even before then. April's coming fast, so. So, Brad, that's the scoop. Terry, thank you. Vinny, good to hear you. And I think that's all I got. Terry?
Yeah, okay. Well, I think we've gone through the list. Does anybody else have anything else to say? W1TR. I guess not. So I guess we'll close the net for this evening. Flying Saucer Net is hereby closed. W1TR.
Awesome. Cool. Good to meet you tonight. You're a rock star now, Terry. Being a article contributor in the thing. But what I'll do for those that can hear me, Vinny. I don't know if I'm gonna put it right to the car reflector, but I'll email you the audio links for the last 3 weeks, and you guys can either listen to them or throw them away. I record 1 hour, so from 9 to 10. But this one I'll stop earlier, obviously. So 73 guys, thanks for keeping it alive. Talk to you next week. W1UJ closing down. What was that, Vinny?
K1BAB, I'm sorry, I can hardly hear you, but I'm here. Okay, thanks, that's good to know. I couldn't hear you on the other antenna, though. I had a lot more noise. This one is a lot quieter, and I can actually hear you clearly. You just aren't coming in very loud, you know. Yeah, 73 then, K1BAB, KB1JEX.